How do I stop email from going to junk in Outlook.com? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question that I got. A newsletter subscription I've had for years recently started going into junk mail. I've had it all along on the junk mail safe senders list. Now I added it as a full contact using the exact email from which it is sent. The daily newsletter still goes into junk mail. It's addressed to my Hotmail address, so not a generic address. What gives? So Outlook.com doesn't make this fix obvious, but as it turns out, it is fairly easy. In fact, it's gotten easier in recent years. Now let's take a look at some steps in Outlook.com to stop emails we want from going into the junk mail folder. First, let's take a look at an example of junk. Here we are in Outlook.com, and you can see that I've got my newsletter, which of course I hope you've subscribed to, newsletter.askleo.com if you haven't. This one, of course, is in the inbox, but if we take a look at the junk email folder, son of a gun, one of the other issues of the newsletter ended up there. That can happen. Sometimes it's all copies of a newsletter or everything from a specific sender. Sometimes, though, it varies depending on the content of a specific newsletter or email. Nonetheless, this one's in spam. So the very first thing we want to do is right-click on it and say report, not junk. Now, this actually automatically will add to the safe senders list the email address that this newsletter came from. So in a sense, it's already taking the first step for us. Now we're back in inbox and we can see that the message was moved over to the inbox from the junk email. Now, let's do this manually. Let's have a look at that safe senders list. Click the gear icon. Click on mail if it doesn't automatically come up, and then click on junk email. You might need to scroll down a little bit, but here you can see safe senders and domains. And of course, we can just click on add safe sender, and then we would type in the email address of the person or source of the emails that we don't want to go to our junk mail folder. As you can tell, it says safe senders and domains. That means we can add, as we did here, a specific email address like leo@askleo.com, or if you want all the email that comes from any email address at askleo.com to never go to junk, you can just add the domain. I'll do that this way. Add safe sender, I'll say askleo.com, and click OK. And this one, of course, is redundant now. We could remove it. In fact, I will. And now, anything that comes from any email address at askleo.com should not go to junk. Now, this is a step that the questioner took. They indicated that they had already added things to their safe senders list. An additional thing that the original questioner did is to add that email address or that sender to their contacts. But there's a catch with this. So I'll hover over the from address in this message and not move the mouse. In a couple of seconds, we get a card, an information card that pops up. And a couple seconds after that, it expands to show more information. Now, it says contact, which to me implies that it found this email address in your contacts, which is not the case. This account for this example has no contacts at all. So I know that it is not already in there. However, if we now move up here to the ellipses, click on that, you can see that it has the add to contacts option. We'll do that. Add to contacts. We can add more information about the email address or the contact that we want, and we'll just say create. As it turns out, this is actually not quite enough. And I say that because there's a setting we now need to look for in our mail settings. So we'll go over to, again, the gear icon, mail, junk email, And now we'll scroll down to security options, where there is this checkbox that says trust email from my contacts. By default, it's not checked. So if you want to use your contacts for this purpose, make sure to come into the settings, junk mail, and make sure that trust email from my contacts is selected. Do that carefully. And I say carefully because now every email address that happens to be in your contacts will never go to junk. On the surface, that sounds like a good thing. But remember, spammers are tricky. Spammers will often spoof email addresses or emails to come from email addresses that you already trust. Those email addresses have actually nothing to do with the true origin of the spam. They're just spoofing the from address with these other email addresses. And if they happen to be email addresses that are in your contacts, then the spammer will have successfully bypassed the junk mail filter if you have this turn on. My sense is that if you're experiencing an issue where a large number of emails from people you trust and are in your contacts are for whatever reason going into junk, turning this on, trusting email from your contacts, is a great place to start to see whether or not this is a better approach to managing spam for you. Now, you'll notice so far that all we've done is the same things that our questioner already said. We've added an email address to the safe senders list. In this case, I also showed you how to add a domain to the safe senders list. And we've added an email address to our contacts. The only thing that might have been missed originally is this trust email from my contact settings. As it turns out, there is an occasional complication specifically with respect to newsletters. And that's because a newsletter might actually come from a different email address than is displayed in the from field. For example, for many, many years, my newsletter was from leo@askleo.com, but it was sent by leo's answers@aweber.com. which later changed to something even more complicated, leo@askleo.com. Now, today, it's back to just plain old leo@askleo.com. The issue is that this is all about spam, or rather, preventing spam. Email newsletters and discussion lists also, groups.io and other scenarios have this exact same problem where they're technically not allowed or not authorized to send email on your behalf. Until they are, as it turns out, there are ways for AWeber to do that, but until they are, they have to make sure that the email they send comes from their own domain, not yours. And that's why they sometimes end up having to play these tricks behind the scenes so that even though it looks like the email comes from leo@askleo.com, the other things that the email system might pay attention to also include information that says, hey, this was really sent by, in my case, aweber.com, in other cases, MailChimp or Kit or any number of other email sending services. Now, here's the thing. Especially in Outlook.com, it's really difficult to determine if one of those other email addresses is being used. Outlook.com itself keeps changing, and it has displayed them in the past, but it's fairly obvious when it does that. But it's also possible that they're completely hidden. The only way to know for certain is to look at the email's full headers for entries related to, from, sent by, reply to, and similar. And yes, I know that's well beyond what most people are comfortable doing. The good news is that in my first example above, simply adding my email provider's domain, aweber.com, to the safe senders list would address them all, whether they're actually being used or not. The other scenario now is that the right-click and add to safe senders, or in my case, not junk, causing that safe senders add to happen automatically, that actually will probably look at the correct email address, whatever that email address might be. So, if you trust all of your contacts, then using Trust Email from My Contacts is probably the easiest solution of all. On the other hand, if you want more control without worrying about your contacts, or you want to allow mail from an entire domain, like maybe askleo.com, the Safe Sender List is probably the most powerful approach. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/122838. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.